Hi guys, this is Harsha. Today I am going to explain about a circuit which was designed by me. It is designed for a particular application, that is in some hospitals or in homes, small infants in the cradle when they cry, the circuit detects the frequency of the infant crying and gives signals to the motors which are connected to the cradle. So whenever infants will cry, the motor will start to swing the cradle to and forth, so the baby stops crying. The main circuit consists of four parts. Here it is the power supply unit. This one is the power supply unit, which converts the 12 volts to or some any constant DC voltage to 9 volts. For that reason, we have to give more than 9 volts to input. And this one is the amplifier. Here you can see a microphone condenser. It is a microphone condenser. The signals which are received by the microphone condenser are get amplified by this amplifier. Here I am using an IC, 358 IC. We are using an LM358, which is a low power dual operation amplifier, which has basically two op amps. I connected them in cascade, and each individual gain of 10, which are contain a negative feedback, so the total overall gain is 100. So signal which is received as the input is multiplied by a gain of 100 and transferred to the next circuit, which is a tone decoder. Here I use the tone decoder LM567. Here is the internal diagram. It is the input, it is the output pin. Here we can see this and a voltage ladder. In the IC, the main application and advantage of the IC is to compute two frequencies and give output only when they are same. Here we can set the frequency by using 6th and 5th pin by using the resistors and capacitor values, and the frequency is given to test 1 and 2, and the input frequency is given to 3, and these two phase detectors detect the input and the reference frequency and gives output to 8th pin. Here a transistor is connected, which will switches to ground when there is a similar frequencies between input and output. The CMOS circuit is shown in here. The R and C values can set for the frequency, and third is the input, and these are the output loop filters which can eliminate the undesired signals and also use it for bandwidth. You can see. Okay, there we go on the circuit. And a timing circuit for which time the cradle should swing to and forth. I designed for a minimum of 30 seconds to a maximum of 13 minutes by using stable mode and IC355. So we can set the cradle to swing to and forth about maximum of 30 minutes. So we can extend the range also by improving the resistor and capacitor values. 1.1 R C, which is a general formula, as you all know. This is the relay, 9 volts relay, which connects to the cradle motor. So basically we don't have a cradle yet. We will show by just by signals facing by the LEDs. Okay. Here we use it to a simulator app to generate the frequencies, audio frequencies, which is a SIQ tab. Here you can see. I am using my new multimeter, which is Unity 181A, to determine the frequencies of input and output, so that you can get clarified about that. Here there is my 12 volt power supply, which can be connected to this circuit and can drive the circuit, whole circuit. Okay, I'm connecting it to my power source.